Now, in order to write JavaScript and HTML, you're going to need a text editor. And there are a number of good ones for this purpose. A lot of people like Komodo, and there are some integrated development environments like WebStorm and PHP Storm and so on. But to keep things simple, I'm just going to use Notepad plus-plus in this course. And it's pretty lightweight. It's installed on all the lab computers, which is an advantage, and pretty easy to get started with. So I'm going to go to another tab and I'm going to search for Notepad plus-plus. And this will take me to the download page. And I'm going to click the download link. It's a small install. Now, I should mention that pretty much any text editor will work, but if you're trying to use something like Simple Text on the Mac, you should be aware that by default, Simple Text will change all of your double quotes to smart quotes, the curly quotes that face left or right, and those will not work. You will get syntax errors in your JavaScript code if you have the wrong kinds of quotes. So it's best to use a text editor that just does straight text. And obviously, if you're using a word processor like Microsoft Word, that is going to save the file as rich text format, and bad stuff will happen. So best to go ahead and download a straight text editor. And then I'm going to install Notepad plus-plus, English, agree. Default location. I'm going to take all the default settings here and install. And then I'm just going to go ahead and run it. And out of the box, this will do most of what you want it to do. It's a little big here. But I want to draw your attention to one thing. Under Settings, Preferences, there should be a language. You'll see that there's a tab size setting, and by default here the tab size is 2 and it's replacing by space, and that's what we're going to be using in this course for indentation. So some people use 4, some people use 2. We're just going to use 2 here. And so make sure that this setting is set correctly on whatever text editor you're using. And let's go ahead and create a file. So new. And then I'm going to save this. So where does this go? Well, if we go back to our XAMPP folder, you'll see there's an htdocs subfolder here. And it already has some stuff. It has this index.php. That's the main page that gets loaded when you go to localhost. And I'm going to right-click here and create a new folder. And I'll call that CIS133W. And I'm not going to put any spaces here to keep my life easier later on. One thing to point out, if you're on the Mac, make sure this htdocs folder is accessible to everybody. So go ahead and select the folder in Finder, go to Get Info, scroll all the way to the bottom, and check the permissions. Make sure that this folder can be read or written by everybody, and that will save you some trouble later on. And do the same thing with the CIS133W folder. Make sure that, that it's readable and writable by everybody. So now I have a folder where I can store some stuff. I'm going to go back to Notepad plus-plus, and before I do anything else, I'm going to save this file as, and then I'm going to navigate to my 133W folder. So C, XAMPP, htdocs, CIS133W, and I'm going to call this week1.html. And I'm doing the save first because that lets Notepad plus-plus take advantage of some built-in language features for HTML. So to test this out, I'm going to start with a simple HTML document. And it's going to have a head. And the title is going to be Week 1. And the head tag, body tag, and we'll put a div box in here. And we'll close off the body tag, and we'll close off the HTML tag. So this is how I'd like you to indent your HTML files, and I'm going to go ahead and save this. And now if I go to Chrome, I should be able to go to localhost slash CIS133W, and there's the file I just created. If I click on it, I have the title week 1 and my div box with this is my week 1 document.